pleases you, Mr. Speaker.
It does.
Mr. Speaker, I rise this morning not only to give an update in relation to where we are with the Bermuda Coast Guard, but also to ensure that we are mindful of the position that we were in prior to the implementation and where we are headed. Mr. Speaker, you and members of this Honorable House would be cognizant that much discussion took place in 2016 in relation to the Royal Bermuda Regiment assuming responsibility for inshore maritime patrolling from the Bermuda Police Service. However, there was very little movement. Prior to that, you would be conscious of the fact that the National Security and the Defense Review report in 2014 identified that the regiment could establish a maritime unit or a Coast Guard in line with the proposal that was presented to Cabinet in February 2013. It was agreed to by the then Commissioner of Police, who had expressed his desire to refocus on law enforcement and to divest and to delegate ancillary services to appropriate third parties. Mr. Speaker, in 2018, this government, working with the Government House, had a proof of concept document developed, which was identified as a possible roadmap to make this concept a reality. On Friday, August 10th, 2018, I stated that the Bermuda Coast Guard would be at full operating capacity by April 2020. I am pleased to say that this ship is sailing on course for meeting that target. Mr. Speaker, the unit will operate jointly for a year under the operational control of the Bermuda Police Service. Although it will allow for the hiring of new members, it is important to note the following. The Defense Coast Guard Unit Amendment Act 2018 not only made it amendment to the Defense Act 1965 and to the Interpretation Act 1951, but it also included the Police Act 1974, the Police Complaint Authority Act 1998, the Police and Criminal Evidence Act 2006, which is PACE, the Police Conduct Orders Act 2016, the Police Performance Orders Act 2016. In short, the members of the Coast Guard will have the same powers and authorities that are conferred by law on the members of the Bermuda Police Service. Many members of the Bermuda Regiment's boat troop had previously been sworn in as special constables with the Bermuda Police Service, giving those powers of authority as police officers. Others will be sworn in shortly. Mr. Speaker, in order to achieve proficiency across a spectrum of tasks associated with inshore Coast Guards, in addition to providing emergency services, which has enforcement functions, especially as it relates to the aforementioned acts and orders, an aggressive training program has been put in place by the project team. The Coast Guard will receive specialist training in addition to law and procedures and will have the opportunity to apply the training this summer. This is a first and the most important phase for 2020. Mr. Speaker, the unit will maintain an inshore Coast Guard in order to secure Bermuda's territorial waters, initially out to 12 nautical miles and beyond, depending on the sea state and available assets. Members of the unit will operate out of the command center at Watford House in the Paris of Sands, providing a 24-hour on-duty capability during the summer boating season. We are working towards the accreditation of the command center and envision that the unit will become a command center of excellence for the other overseas territories. Mr. Speaker, last year in 2019, Government House identified a Coast Guard advisor from the Royal Navy, Commander Marcus Jacks. This gentleman has over 31 years' experience with the Royal Navy. He has been working closely with the Royal Bermuda Regiment and the Bermuda Police Service, making the concept of the Bermuda Coast Guard unit a reality. Mr. Speaker, Commander Jack has been working with representatives from both the Bermuda Regiment and the Bermuda Police Service and has developed a plan in a phased approach over the next 5 years. The main focus at this time is ensuring that the men and women of the Coast Guard are satisfactorily trained in search and rescue, marine safety, marine security, accident and disaster response, pollution response, vessel and traffic management, customs and border control, fisheries control, and law enforcement. Mr. Speaker, members have been fortunate to receive the training in relation to shore cleaning and assessment techniques and oil spill response. This training was put on by the Department of Environment and Natural Resources. The Foreign and Commonwealth Office has also provided the Royal Navy International Marine Training and an addition to small craft handling and navigation. The Royal Yachting Association, or the RYA, has provided training to members of the Coast Guard, which will assist them in obtaining the internationally recognized Royal Yachting Association boating qualifications. The intent is to ensure all members of the Coast Guard receive standardized training, making it easier for them to achieve full accreditation. We must ensure that the Bermuda meets the International Maritime Organization, or the IMO, triple one code inspection towards the end of this year, which, amongst other things, will be focusing on our search and rescue capacities requiring 24-hour coverage. Mr. Speaker, the Newport to Bermuda Yacht Race is due to commence in June 19, 2020, with the first vessels arriving on June 20th through 24th. This will be the first major event taking place this summer. The Coast Guard will play a significant role and will be assuming responsibility for 1, search and rescue with the 12-mile limit, partnering with the marine imports, and if it should be required, marine transport, and support to sister agencies, customs, immigration, and fire, as required to relation to bespoke operations. 3, port security of the Hamilton area and surrounding environments where yachts will dock, possibly St. George's and Dockyard, depending on the number of entrants. Marine enforcement. 5, disaster response and management. There will also be a tabletop exercise, Mr. Speaker, prior to the event. Mr. Speaker, in relation to the boats being used, I want to emphasize that these are not new boats. Both the Bermuda Regiment and the Bermuda Police Service have had their boats surveyed and refurbished to meet the initial requirement in order to make the Coast Guard a requirement. Mr. Speaker, in relation to the financial implication for this year, 2020, regarding the Coast Guard, I can state that both the Bermuda Police Service and the Royal Bermuda Regiment have worked really hard in identifying funding within their current budget to establish the Coast Guard. As we move forward to 2021 and the next phase of the plan, additional funding will be required as we make Bermuda Coast Guard its own entity. Mr. Speaker, we have come a long way, but I recognize there is still a lot of work to be done. To ensure that we continue to meet our medium to long-term plans, a steering committee has been created in addition to a project team. The project team continues to meet on an almost daily basis. The launch of the Bermuda Coast Guard is a significant milestone for us as we evolve this new service. Finally, Mr. Speaker, and members of this House, I wish again to congratulate all those involved in ensuring the success of our new Coast Guard unit. To the men and women of the Bermuda Coast Guard, I am aware that there were some storming before the new norming of this new unit as it becomes a reality. But I am aware, and I want to leave you with this quote: life's roughest storms prove that there are strength in our anchors. Always remember, hope lies within the anchors of our soul. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.